Man, I'm so excited about this, man. You know, we've done a lot to try to sit back and do what's right in the terms of getting folks what they need. Everybody has a starting point, and for us, I think sometimes folks don't really know what it takes to take a helmet from a concept to storyboard or to retail. It's time consuming, man, and you know, we've had to learn, I guess, I don't want to say about the hard knocks of life, but we've done the best that we can. And so this right here is a pretty big accomplishment. We still got so much more that we're working on and that we plan or have planned and teed up that, you know, at some point, as soon as it gets accomplished, we'll be able to send to market. For some people, if you were a guy like, I've got a big head, man, I'm a 7 5/8 in the fitted. And so, hey, my present shell, it looked at home on my head. And then somebody that might be a true small, extra small, not so much, man. And so they got kind of the mushroom head. And, you know, we wanted to sit back and avoid that and help folks out with the smaller dimensions. But again, it all is a part of the overall cost that you put into a product. And you have to get a whole tool created to do that. And so this is our answer for those folks. But we even went a step further, man, which I'm so excited. This thing has been engineered to death. So we still are gonna have our original shell that's gonna be for the guys that are now a double XL or 3X, and it's gonna be perfect for them guys. It always has been. But for your folks that are in the 7, 7 1/4, 7 1/2, all the way down to the 6 and 5/8, man, this is it, man. And it was engineered so well that this thing even fits my head. And man, the smaller it is, the doper it is, the more the aesthetic that we've always that you're trying to achieve in the first place, which is this to mimic a hat, is achieved. And so this thing even fits my head, and I'm a 7 5/8, so that's the little liner, the little bag to sit back and wipe it off, fingerprints or whatever. But man, I'm so thrilled about this thing. It just, man, a lot of hard work. I'm excited about it, and I just can't say enough that we were able to get this thing engineered and dialed in. It still fits low, eyebrow line, how you like to wear them. Some of you cats like to tuck them big ass ears. This is it, baby. So I'm excited about it, man, and I can't say enough about Flat Boy. Let's talk about Doughboy 2.0 now. And it's got that more aggressive bend, that more bobber look. When we put stuff underneath the bottom of it, man, the visibility is real high because of how much real estate is there to be seen because of the aggressive bend. And so that's Doughboy 2.0, man. And I tell you what, guys, man, this thing is so dope, man. Feels good, fits well. And again, we engineered and got it dialed in so much that it even fits my head, and I'm a 7 5/8. So for that person that is a small, extra small, change out the liner. The outer shell is smaller. You won't have the mushroom look, man. And man, it's right on point, man. And I love it to death. I'm so excited about this thing. It's been a long time coming. We've been offering Doughboy 2.0 in the old lid, but a lot of people didn't even realize, man, that we didn't have a tool made for it. So my painters, man, they were getting heat guns and shit and heating the brim up and giving it that more aggressive bend than just regular Doughboy, who has just a slight bend, versus 2.0, who has a more aggressive bend. But hey, I've got some talented guys, and they're problem solvers. They're just slick cats, man, and that's how we were giving people the Doughboy 2.0 look with the old shell. And a lot of people were like, well, man, I want to just order a Doughboy 2.0 off the website. Well, man, we didn't have it to give you. Well, guys, we went and made the tool. It's coming to the website. You can order it, do your thing. Look at that thing. Man, that's dope as hell. Got the Mike's Pro List sticker on it. I'm excited about it, man. So Doughboy 2.0, for all you artists out there, man, it's gonna be on the website. And something else that we're doing, man, that I'm really excited about, for the folks to achieve their sizing, man, we would have to literally, a lot of times when you buy a helmet, you're concerned about sizing because, you know, you hate to sit back, and especially a custom one. You order a custom helmet and you feel like you got your sizing dialed in, but you're always like, man, before I spend this money, I'd hate to get it and the size is wrong. Man, it's gonna come standard with two liners, man, so we're not gonna miss nobody on sizing. It's gonna be legit. You're gonna be purchase with confidence as far as the sizing. The sizing no longer becomes an issue, man, based off of that. Look how low that thing sits on my brow. Cheese. Whatever. Anyhow, I'm excited about it, man, and so lots of hard work, man, to get it there. But we got it there. And something else that's really cool, man, and anticipation for releasing the new lids. You can go on the website, man, and you can see a lid you like. Basically, you can do customs on the website, man, which is gonna be so dope, man. If you want your name underneath there, and the website functions really well. They've done a great job, some smart guy shit to make it flow and function the way it needs to. And so I'm excited about that, man. And it's been a lot of work, but hopefully you folks are digging what we've tried to do to make this thing simpler and get these out there. We're gonna offer them in the standard colors. We will be coming right behind the back though with the Hydro Dips in the 2.0s, Flat Boy, and Doughboy. They're coming, guys, and they'll be on the website in just a moment, man. We're just trying to build up the inventory.